So, as we all know, or maybe some of you don't, and you're just checking out project management applications, well, project management apps have this feature in them normally called Gantt. And basically, it's a timeline or a Gantt chart. A lot of people call it in a different way, but it's a chart that helps you represent project progress and keep an eye on everything in a very visual manner. And it's been used for a very long time. Today, we're going to dive into 10 project management applications that really hone in on this experience. And Gantt can be a very helpful process for project planning. So hopefully these can be helpful in helping you find the best project manager if Gantt is something that you really, really want to have inside of your application. So I'm going to go through this list and dive into some recommendations. Now, if you are new here, it'd be amazing to have you as a subscriber. Feel free to hit subscribe and join Keep Productive for plenty more project management and also plenty of productivity software reviews. So the first on our list is a really well-respected, well-renowned Gantt application. It's called Gantt Pro. Now, as you can imagine, Gantt Pro has been on the market for some time now, and it's actually a really attractive looking application. It has apparently 700,000 teams using it, and it has some really nice abilities in it, especially when you're being able to collaborate with other people and specifically in real time. Now, it's got some great functions that, for example, commenting can be done and being able to keep progress with everyone at the right time. And the visual project management in being able to connect a project to another task is actually really helpful. So Gantt Pro goes highly recommended in this set of applications. Now, next up is Team Gantt. And this actually has been on the market for some time as well. And it is great for setting up project plans and being able to create dependencies, hierarchies, and stuff you'd expect inside of a Gantt application. But what differs to many of the others is it has a board view. Now, whilst the design isn't necessarily amazing, it also has templates to help you save some valuable time setting things up. But it is great to get started with and fairly easy to roll into. Number three on our list is Smartsheet. Now, Smartsheet, again, has been around for a little bit of time, but it's really presenting itself in a very professional way recently by allowing you to do great capture inside of one sheet. It does what it says on the tin. It's very much to sheet focused. However, they do have some alternative views like grid view, Gantt view, card view, and calendar view for expressing your information in different ways. And it's got a really clean looking design. And a lot of people say that they really like this for automating workflows. And it is as well backed by security IT needs as well. It looks it looks a little bit like Asana 2, which does make it nice to come into and be able to get started with. Next up is Microsoft Project. Now, actually, Microsoft Project has been around for a fair bit of time. It is well renowned in the space as a great project experience, and it's been growing in popularity mainly because of the function it's got with Microsoft Loop, allowing you to collaborate in teams on a Microsoft project without even having to leave Microsoft Teams. So if you're a Microsoft Teams user, in the next couple of months, it's going to become really predominant as a feature. So as you can imagine, if that's something that you've got a Microsoft Teams plan and you want to be able to take more advantage of it, well, Microsoft Project will become much more of a functional experience without you having to leave Teams, which for a lot of people, they don't want to have to switch applications on a regular basis. Now, moving on, we have got Toggle Plan. Now, Toggle Plan is actually an application that came much more from time tracking. However, Toggle Plan now allows you to plot your time ahead and allow you to visually plan with you and your team. And to be honest, this application is great for workload management, especially when you want to be able to move things to other people's duties and also keep track of milestones and drag tasks in as well. And whilst it's not necessarily traditionally a Gantt view, this will help you to manage your team, but not necessarily in a more sort of modern and sort of time orientated way. Next up is Rike. Now, Rike is a really popular application with sales and marketing, and it's great for managers as well, but it does have a wide variety of views, including list, table, board, and timeline, which is their Gantt view, and also a stream view if you're looking to manage your work through a more feed-based scenario. But again, much like some of these more all-round applications, this can help you to keep focused and work in a wide variety of ways if it's not suitable for you. Now, next up is Backlog, and this is actually developed from a company called NewLab, and I've seen a couple of their projects before. Now, whilst the design isn't hugely attractive, it's used by a lot of development teams, so as you can imagine, design might not be 100% their thing, but it gets the job done in a lot of scenarios. But there's a great Gantt view in it that allows you to see your data as a Gantt chart and be able to go into a high level of filtering and grouping and status management. And you can even export the data as a Excel as well. But it is really effective for managing your team. Now, next up, again, not focused towards their Gantt abilities, but there are not as many entirely Gantt-focused applications, but ClickUp actually have an amazing Gantt view, as well as Monday.com. I'm going to put these as like 8 and 9, just because their Gantt views are really functional, and as you can imagine, they've come leaps and bounds in the last few years. And as you can imagine, in the paid plans, they can allow you to go a lot further in ClickUp and both Monday. So they come in at 8 and 9, and I definitely recommend checking the videos out below that dive a little bit deeper into them. Now, finally, I do want to give a head nod to Notion, because a lot of people are looking at this. Whilst it does have a Gantt view, it's much more simple. But what's beneficial with Notion is the Gantt view is actually a database view, so you can go quite aggressive on the properties, filters, and grouping, and also create some really powerful integrations. So it's well worth exploring Notion if your team is very wiki-based and you've got a huge focus on sort of managing siloed information inside of your sort of applications and message apps as well. But anyway, as you can imagine, these are all great Gantt experiences that I'd highly recommend checking out. Some of the ones at the start, much more suitable for the Gantt experience and more specialist, but the others near the end, all great all-rounders that I highly recommend checking out. Anyway, folks, if you're new to the channel, please do make sure you subscribe and follow Keep Productive for more. If you want to comment below with a Gantt application I haven't checked out, feel free to do so, and I'll check it out for sure. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll speak to you all very soon. Cheerio.